information protection can require a considerable amount of coordination to guard your organization. Data Loss Prevention, or DLP, is one of the Office 365 features that helps protect your users when handling sensitive information. To configure a DLP policy, we start at the Security and Compliance Center. We choose Data Loss Prevention, then choose Policy. We'll next click on Create a Policy. Microsoft provides templates that you can use when configuring your first policies. Let's go ahead and choose the All Countries dropdown and choose United States, if that's where you're located. We can then choose Financial, Medical and Health, Privacy, or Create Custom Policies. Let's start off with the Financial Policy, and we'll just look at U.S. financial data. When we choose that, you'll see that that tells us that it protects credit cards, U.S. bank accounts, and ABA routing numbers. We'll then click Next. You'll want to go ahead and create a custom name for your policy and provide a description, then click Next. For choosing location, this is not a geographic location, but where the data is stored. So we'll want to go ahead and by default choose all locations in Office 365. This includes all Exchange emails, OneDrive, and SharePoint documents. Go ahead and select Next, and then let's look at the types of data. Now let's say that this policy is going to be for protecting our users from sending financial information outside of our organization. So again, we can see the content's going to be protected, and then in this drop-down box in the center of the screen, you'll see we can select whether this is for people outside my organization or when we're sharing with people inside. So let's go ahead and keep the default of people outside my organization selected. We'll then click Next. Now let's look at what we want the system to do if it detects sensitive information. The first selection is about notifying users. So we'd certainly want to do that, to show them a policy tip and send them an email notification. We can also control if we're looking for a specific amount. Again, we'll just accept the defaults here. And we also want to send incident reports by email, which will send both you and the global admin an email when there's an issue. Go ahead and click Next. And then it asks us, do we want to go ahead and turn the policy on right away, test it, or keep it turned off? Most of the time, we recommend that you go ahead and test it first, and if you'd like, go ahead and choose Show Policy Tips while in test mode. This will not restrict users from sending emails or taking actions on sensitive information, but it will warn them you may be handling sensitive information. Go ahead and click Next, and we can review the settings and then click Create, and that will create our first DLP policy.